The answer is none of them. They was all perfectly fine cash machines, there was nothing wrong with them. The problem is, how could you ever tell? Because as you've just seen, on the same run of cash machines, on the same bank, some of the cash machines look really bright and flashy and brand new, but then immediately next to it there's an old battered weathered one. And it's really difficult to know if the cash machine's been tampered with or not. I've worked in a bank myself. Checks are made on the cash machines to make sure that nothing's been tampered with or nothing's been stuck on it. But that makes no difference, because once the check's done, as soon as you've turned your back, anyone can put something on that machine. Banks could do a better job of protecting people against cash machine fraud. They could easily just take a picture of the cash machine, showing you how it's supposed to look, and stick it on the inside of the bank, on the glass, right next to it, and saying, if the cash machine doesn't look like this, don't use it. As simple as that. Because people were most at risk of cash machine fraud is people really on lower incomes who are more likely to use cash machines. But really, everyone's at risk on a weekend. And banks obviously closed on a weekend. Some of them are open on Saturdays, but not full hours. And obviously, a lot of banks are shut on weekends. That is when most cash machine fraud is done, because it's the easiest time to do it. That's usually when the cash machines are filled up almost to the maximum of the cash amount. That's why cash machines are mostly robbed on a weekend. Cash machines are less likely to be checked on a weekend as well, because there's no one in the bank to check them. So a really easy way for banks to protect the customers would be to take a picture of the cash machine and put it on the glass on the inside of the bank and proper seal it onto the glass so that it can't be tampered with, to show what a cash machine is meant to look like at their branches. And if they have had to install the one brand new one, obviously then you've got the picture to know that the cash machine looks right. Obviously there's other things they can do as well. Obviously some of the fake fronts of cash machines can look really convincing, but there's usually always something to give them away. And it could easily be something like a code on the cash machine to make sure it's the same code as the one on the glass, on the picture, you know, and they could change that every now and again, you know. They could have an official sticker. It would get a bit more expensive, I suppose, but they could easily stick that piece of glass on the inside of the cover of the screen, if you get my drift. Because when you open a cash machine, you know, you can really get into the nooks and crannies of everything of it. So even if it was handwritten, you know, that every weekend they could just write on the inside of the cash machine, on the glass bit, what you look at to see how much money you don't have. They could write on the top corner of the glass inside the number, and then write that on the piece of paper, what they've stuck in the window with the cash machine picture on it. Really, really easy. Extremely easy. But would they do it? I don't know. So things to look out for on dodgy cash machines is usually the cover, what they've put, the where you put your card in. But because there's so many different manufacturers, it's difficult to know. I mean, every now and again you give them a wiggle, but they can be so well stuck on, it's difficult to tell. But another thing is any damaged or blurred writing. Anybody want an ice cream? Yeah, so look for blurred writing. Look for something that doesn't look quite right. If you're ever in doubt, just don't use the cash machine. Don't put yourself at risk. But yeah, come on, the banks, it's a very easy thing to do. Take a picture of your own cash machines, stick it on the glass so that customers know what the cash machine is meant to look like and if there is anything suspicious. And over the weekends, you know, maybe take it out the window, write a code on it, stick it back in the glass, then open the cash machine and write on the glass inside the cash machine on the screen so that the customers can still see the writing behind it. But you know what I mean? If you work in a bank, you'll know what I mean. And then that way, everyone's then sure that the machine that they're using is the same one that's on the picture. It's not 100%, but I think it's a very quick, simple, easy way. There we go, that's my video on that. Thanks for watching. Please scratch that one in the comment section down below if you think that's a good idea or a bad idea. Let me know if you've ever been ripped off at a cash machine. Have you had your card skimmed at a cash machine, or anyone robbed you at a cash machine? I've had people being too close to me at a cash machine and I've just completely cancelled the transaction. I always cover my PIN number over when I'm putting it in. Some scams mean that they've got fake keypads. You know, this is another reason why banks should take a picture of the cash machines so we know by looking at the glass on the inside of the bank so we know what we're doing. Thanks for watching. Scrass, bye. Well, I had to run out and get an ice cream. Lovely. So check your card machine. Check the screen. Have an ice cream. We're never getting cash out the cash machine. Scratch, bye. It's really nice.